Welcome back to story time. I hope you had a great year of 2021. And as we look ahead to the new year which will soon approach us, let us think of some great devotees and saints of our land who will inspire us and help us to tread the right path throughout this new year. One such saint is Sant Choka Mela of Maharashtra. When he was little, he lived in a village in the Solapur district called Mangalwede. He belonged to the lowest of the lowest sections of society. And in those days, which was towards the end of 13th century, untouchability, the caste system had all reached a very low depth. And so, society was divided by these artificial barriers. People would differentiate from each other on the basis of caste and birth. And so it was, this little boy Choka Mela was playing with his friends. He was still innocent and so did not know that he belonged to a family of Mahars which the others considered as lowly. So as he was playing, one day from the temple in the far distance, he could hear the temple bells. The temple bells kept ringing because it was the time of the evening aarti. He felt that he ought to go to the place from where these divine sounds seemed to be coming. And so he ran towards the temple. Now it was time of the aarti, so everybody was busy there. Nobody noticed this little boy, and he made his way amongst the crowds and reached the very sanctum sanctorum, or the main garbhagriha of the temple, where the idol is kept and where the priests were performing the aarti. When the priests saw this little boy, they got furious because it was those days when certain sections of people were not allowed inside the temple premises. And they were shocked that Choka Mela dared to enter and cross the limits. And so they grew furious and they threw him out. Now little Choka could not understand the reason for this behavior, and so he asked them. And they told him, You dirty fellow, don't you know that you are not pure enough or clean enough to enter the temple? And Choka replied, I have taken a bath, I wash my clothes daily, don't I look clean enough just like all of you? But nobody gave him a clear answer, and they just beat him and took him out of the temple and left him crying by the wayside. Now, though the villagers saw the crying boy, nobody showed any sympathy because the times were such that everybody thought that it was totally preposterous that Choka Mela could ever get darshan of the Lord inside the temple. As Choka grew up, his longing to see the idol inside the temple grew more and more strong till he could not bear it any longer. He tried again and again, but nobody would ever allow him to even cross the gate of the temple. So finally, he decided that he would leave his village. He thought that maybe the people of his village were very hard and fast about these rigid rules, but the other villages would be better. But wherever he went, people would stop him. People would recognize him just from his way of speaking, his manner of dressing, the color of his skin. Choka was heartbroken. He could not understand the ways of the man, neither the ways of the Lord. Till one day, he saw a group of Varkaris. Now we know that the Varkaris are those devotees and pilgrims who travel by foot all the way to Pandharpur, singing Vitthala, 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 Vitthala. And these Varkaris do not believe in any kind of distinctions whatever. They are all unified by their love for the Lord Vitthala. And suddenly Choka Mela felt a kind of peace creeping into his heart. He too joined them and he walked the entire distance up to Pandharpur. When he reached Pandharpur, he had a dip in the holy river and then did pradakshina of the temple and prostrated in front of the temple, but just at the gate boundaries. Even standing there, he experienced so much bliss that he prayed to the Lord in gratitude. Overhearing his prayers, the temple priest, suddenly cast an eye on him and said, "It is good that you are praying from this place, for you will not be allowed entry inside." Now Chokamela was disturbed, so he went back to the riverside, but he realized that the way of the Varkari life was meant for him. He decided that he would keep chanting the name of Vitthala and gain that peace of mind that had eluded him for so many years. He had lost hope. At times he felt that the temple bells had stopped speaking to him, but now in Pandharpur he felt a kind of peace. So he began singing abhangs and prayers and worshipping in the way he knew best, till one day he felt a strange longing growing inside him. He kept feeling that the Lord Vitthala was calling out to him. He kept asking the Lord, "Why do you keep me away from you? Don't you want your devotees to see you?" And he felt the Lord was calling out to him, "Come Choka, I do not discriminate among the devotees. I have never kept my gate shut for you. What stops you? Come in." And feeling that this was a call from the Lord, Chokamela started walking. As if in a trance, he did not know whether it was right or wrong. He did not know whether the priest would approve or not. But his legs kept moving till he reached the temple gates, which were bolted because it was dark. It was the time of the night when the temples were closed. He could now hear the voice of Vitthala telling, "Open the bolt of the gate, come in. What is stopping you?" And so, in a trance, Chokamela opened the gate bolts. He entered, and when he looked at the idol of Vitthala, he could not contain himself. He went and hugged the feet of the Lord and fell down in a swoon. He was not conscious of anything around him except for the sheer joy that he felt at finally getting the darshan of his dear Lord Vitthala. Now, soon it was daybreak, the time when the temple priest would come in. When the temple priest entered the gates of the temple and saw that the doors were open, he was surprised. And yet, when he looked inside, he saw that Chokamela was there hugging the feet of the idol. This was sacrilege. He could not believe that Chokamela had dared to do this. He screamed at poor Choka and told him, "How dare you make this idol impure? How dare you come and defile the temple premises? Did you not get scared? Don't you have any fear of the Lord?" While Choka innocently said, "It was the Lord himself who called me. How can I defile the temple? How can I, even though I am a Mahar, pollute the great God himself? Can a sinner pollute the Ganga when he takes a dip in its waters?" Now the priest could bear it no longer. He did not want to hear lectures or discussions or debates with this insolent Mahar, and so he threw him out of the temple and told him that he ought to leave the town of Pandharpur. And Chokamela was totally dejected by this. He knew that he could no longer get a darshan of the Lord, for the word of the priest was final. And so he decided he would reside across the banks of the river. He would leave Pandharpur, but from the far distance could still get a glimpse of the temple. And he settled in a small hut. There he kept asking the Lord, "Why did you call me if finally you had to have me thrown out? Is this fair on your part? Can you do this to a true devotee of yours?" And the Lord answered. The Lord gave a reply from his deep core within. The Lord said, "Choka, I reside in your heart. Why do you have to search for me outside? In the temple of your heart, you will always find me." And hearing this, Choka again got his peace. He felt full of joy and bliss, and he became so happy that he began composing abhangs, praising his beautiful and dear Lord. Meanwhile, the priest began to feel very anxious. He did not know whether he was right or wrong, whether the words of Choka were really true. So, to test him, the priest visited Choka's hut. Standing outside, he began to listen to what Choka seemed to be speaking. And it was almost as if Choka was having a conversation with the Lord. So suddenly, the priest barged into the hut. And on coming in, he began searching for the person who was speaking to Choka, and there was nobody. How could he find the Lord of Choka's hut there? And immediately he jumped to a conclusion that Choka Mela was pretending. He was a fraud, he was an imposter, and getting very angry and telling Choka that you seem to be duping all of us, saying that Vitthala is speaking to you, you deserve to be punished. And he slapped Choka. But Choka was undisturbed. Initially, when people used to hurl abuses at him, would humiliate him on the basis of his caste, Choka would always feel sad. But now nothing mattered, because he had found that the Lord resided in himself, and so the ways of the world were immaterial to him. And seeing Choka Mela being so calm disturbed the priest even more. He left in a huff and rushed to the temple. In the temple, there was a shock waiting for him. When he ran in to see the idol of Lord Vitthala, one cheek of Lord Vitthala was swollen. The priest immediately realized what a plunder, what a sin he had committed, because by slapping the devotee of the Lord, he had hurt the Lord himself. He fell at the feet of the idol and crying, weeping, he rushed back to Choka Mela's hut. He fell at the feet of Choka Mela and asked him to forgive him. And taking Choka Mela with him, though Choka did not understand what was happening, he begged that Choka come with him. The priest led Choka to the temple, and on entering the temple, when they looked at the idol, they saw that Lord Vitthala was the same once again. The swelling on the cheek had gone, and the Lord stood there with hands on his hips, smiling as sweetly as before. And the priest knew that he had been forgiven. So Choka Mela continued his devotion now. He could continue getting his darshan whenever he wanted. And he lived for the rest of his life devoted to his dear Lord Vitthala. Now his caste, his birth, the color of his skin, his speech, nothing mattered to anyone anymore. The biggest lesson had been learned, that the devotee and the Lord can never be separated. I hope you like the story of Sant Choka Mela, and if you did, do share it with your friends. And I will be back with another story next Thursday. Until we meet again, Hari Om.